Hello students, welcome back. Today I will discuss about the breast complications. Introduction: A midwife must ensure that the baby is adequately fed at the breast. She must help the mother to develop necessary skills to feed her baby by herself. It means the midwife or the nurse must educate the mother regarding the breastfeeding techniques. The nurse must know about the different breast conditions which may affect on feeding and many complications which can arise after the delivery. So the nurse should encourage the mother or educate the mother regarding the breast care during the pregnancy and after delivery. Anatomical variations in breast: long nipple, inverted and flat nipple, short nipple and abnormally large nipple. Long nipples, it leads to poor feeding because the baby is able to latch on to the nipple without tying the breast tissue into his mouth. It means feeding will be poor because baby is not able to get its mouth into the correct position around the nipple. Short nipples, it does not cause any problem as the baby has to form a teat from both the breast and the nipple. It means the baby sucks in order to get milk and automatically the nipples will protrude. Abnormally large nipple. In this case, if the baby is small, then his or her mouth may not be able to get beyond the nipple and on the breast. It means baby is not able to get adequate feeding. Lactation should be initiated by expressing. The mother must squeeze the milk out of the breast to store it and feed it to the baby later. Inverted and flat nipple. Nipples may be inverted or flat. In this case, if the nipple is deeply inverted, it is necessary to initiate the lactation by expressing or squeezing the breast. Other breast complications are breast engorgement, cracked and retracted nipple, mastitis, deep breast pain. Breast engorgement causes swelling of the breast due to an increase in the blood and the lymph supply as a precursor to the lactation. Onset, it manifests after the milk secretion starts on the third or the fourth day of the postpartum. Symptoms of breast engorgement: considerable pain and feeling of tenseness or heaviness in both the breasts. Generalized malaise and transient rise of the temperature. The temperature will rise for the short time also. Painful breastfeeding. The breasts are hard, often odomatous, painful and sometimes flushed. How breast engorgement can be prevented? First of all, to avoid the pre-lacteal feeds. Pre-lacteal feeds means any food except mother's milk provided to a newborn before initiating the breastfeeding. The pre-lacteal feeding is a major barrier to exclusive feeding. Then, to initiate the breastfeeding early and feeding at the frequent intervals. Exclusive breastfeeding on demand, then feeding in the correct position is the best method to prevent the breast engorgement. Breast engorgement can also be prevented by wearing the proper size bracer and applying the binder. Frequent suckling and manual expulsion of any remaining milk after each feed. It means the mother must squeeze the breast after each feed. To administer analgesic for pain, the baby should be put to the breast regularly at the frequent intervals. In a severe case, gentle use of a breast pump. This will reduce the tension in the breast without causing the excess milk production. Gentle hand expression of the milk to make the breast soft so that the infant can latch on. The mother should apply her hand on the breast so that there will be a proper attachment between the infant's mouth and the breast. Then provide moist heat and cold compression to relieve the edema. Treatment for the breast engorgement. milk suppressive drugs, for example, bromocriptine 2.5 mg daily for 2 to 3 days should be administered in cases where the breast remains tight even after suckling or the expulsion. Then fluid intake should not be restricted. The mother should take up plenty of fluids. Cabbage leaves can be applied. It is a best home remedy for the breast engorgement. Cracked and retracted nipple causes. Unclean hygiene resulting in the formation of crust over the nipple. If mother does not clean the breast or the nipple after each feed, there are chances of cracked nipple. Then retracted nipple, if not treated, may convert into the cracked nipples. Prevention. Local cleanliness during pregnancy and in the puerperium before and after each breastfeeding to prevent the crust formation over the nipple. The mother should be encouraged for the breast cleanliness or the breast care during the pregnancy. It may prevent the cracked and the retracted nipple. Then treatment. Applying tincture benzoin after the night feeding. Nipples are to be kept dry and exposed to air. Gentian violet is applied over the nipple as well as the baby's mouth in case of oral thrush. If all these fail to heal up, then rest is given to the affected nipple for the 24 hours and breasts are strapped with the tight bandages. In severe cases, breast feeding has to be suspended to prevent the mastitis, because if the treatment is not given, this condition may change into the mastitis. Treatment for the retracted nipple. Manually pulling out of the retracted nipple during last 2 months of the pregnancy is useful to rectify the defect. The midwife or the nurse should educate the mother that she should pull out the retracted nipple manually. It may crack the defect. After delivery, nipple is pulled out by suction action of the disposable syringe. Treatment for the breast engorgement. Milk suppressive drugs, for example, bromocriptine 2.5 mg daily for 2 to 3 days should be administered in cases where the breast remains tight even after suckling or the expulsion. Then fluid intake should not be restricted. The mother should take up plenty. Mastitis. Mastitis is an inflammation of the breast. Non-infective or acute inflammatory action occurs during the early days as a result of unresolved engorgement. It may also develop at any time when poor feeding techniques result in the milk not being efficiently removed by the baby from one or more segment of the breast. It means that the main cause of mastitis will be the poor feeding techniques, because due to these poor feeding techniques, the milk will remain or retained inside the breast and it may cause mastitis. Infective mastitis is caused by the damage to the epithelium, which allows bacteria to enter the underlying tissues. Milk stasis will increase further and ideal condition for the pathogenic bacteria to replicate. In case of ignorance, the pathogenic bacteria will be replicate and make the condition more worse. Clinical features for the mastitis. Generalized malaise and headache, fever with chills and rigor in case of pathogenic bacteria, severe pain and tender swelling in one quadrant of the breast, presence of wedge-shaped swelling on the breast with its apex at the nipple, the overlying skin is hot and flushed, feels tense and tender. Treatment for the retracted nipple. Manually pulling out of the retracted nipple during last 2 months of the pregnancy is useful to rectify the defect. The midwife or the nurse should educate the mother that she should pull out the retracted nipple manually. It may crack the defect. After delivery, nipple is pulled out by suction action of the disposable syringe. treatment for the breast engorgement. Milk suppressive drugs, for example, bromocriptine 2.5 mg daily for 2 to 3 days should be administered in cases where the breast remains tight even after suckling or the expression. Then fluid intake should not be restricted. The mother should take up plenty of fluids. Cabbage leaves can be applied. It is the best home remedy for the breast engorgement. Sign and symptoms of breast abscess. Flushed breast not responding to the antibiotics promptly. If the breast is hot or red colored, it will not treat immediately after giving the antibiotics. Brainy edema of the overlying skin. There will be a fluid accumulation inside the breast, marked tenderness and swinging temperature. Treatment. It is to be drained under the general anesthesia by a deep radial incision extending near the areolar margin to prevent injury of the lactiferous duct. The accumulated fluid under the breast is drained out by giving an incision on the areolar margin. Students, we have covered the topic breast complications. If you have any question related to this topic, then please ask me. Okay, students, thank you.